Hello, my name is Chris Enns. I run Lemon Productions, a podcast editing and production business, and this is my story. In this episode, I'm going to be wrapping up the who, what, when, where, and why of podcasting. So this episode, episode 11, is the end of the series I started back in episode 6 with defining what a podcast is. So if you're just joining the show now, it's probably worth going back and listening to episodes 6 through 10 to get caught up. In episode 7, I talked about the why of podcasting. Why do people or businesses start a podcast these days? Episode 8 was all about who should start podcasting. And if you're still listening to this podcast, the answer is probably you. In episode 9, I talked about when you should start a podcast and when, ideally, in the week, you should publish your podcast. Timing is everything on that, and you don't want to overcommit to an idea or not follow through on what you said you deliver and disappoint listeners. And then last episode, I talked about where and how you should host your podcast. So going back to episode 9 for a moment, I had sent out a poll in that episode, and I wanted to update you on the data that I got back from all the responses. Basically, the questions in the poll were around when people listen to podcasts as a way of trying to figure out when it would be best to release your own podcast episodes each week. With only 14 responses, I wouldn't say it's enough data to draw any serious conclusions, but it's still interesting to look at. So let's go. The first question was, what day of the week do you prefer to listen to podcasts on? And almost everybody picked every day of the week, Monday to Friday, with half choosing Saturday and Sunday, which makes sense. Lots of folks use podcasts as part of their commute to or from work or even at work, or when their kids are in school at home. Weekends are when you're getting other stuff done and maybe you can't play podcasts or you don't have time to listen to them. The second question was, what time of day do you generally listen to podcasts? And the majority, 11 of you, picked early morning / commute to work. Now, I had a few people tell me afterwards that there wasn't a commute home from work option, so something to remember for next time I do a quick poll on a whim. The third question was, what kind of podcast do you wish was out there but haven't been able to find yet? And this was a fill-in-the-blank answer, so there's obviously a variety of responses. So you might get some tips if you're trying to start a podcast on what's kind of missing and what people are finding in the podcast listings. One person said true crime or criminal investigations outside of the US, for example, Japan. Another person said one that interviews only businesses that have reached $1 million in annual revenue. Another podcast idea is cleaning tips. Another person said more documentary series that aren't murder and true crime like The Dream. Some parents and family responses here. One person said they wish there was a podcast about raising kids on the autism spectrum, which I find it hard to believe there isn't, but maybe there isn't any good ones, I guess, on that already. Sometimes some of the niche topics are so hard to find the actual good shows in there or shows that are ongoing. That's definitely an issue in podcasting, is podcast discovery. Another person said special parenting topics, so family parenting podcasts, which again, it feels like there's a lot of parenting or family related podcasts, but it tends to be a lot of either mommy blogger types or dads, or maybe it's just like needs to be parents as a unit talking about parenting. Good movie reviews, more history podcasts. Another person said interviews with micro influencers. So there's some ideas for any of you looking to start a podcast. The fourth question was, what podcast do you listen to that you find yourself recommending most often? And again, this was a fill-in-the-blank style answer, so everybody has a different response, of course. One person said Earl Grey podcast, which I think is a Star Trek podcast, not a tea podcast. Another person responded with, it changes constantly, but currently it's Patient Zero from NHPR. That might have been NPR, now that I think about it, but maybe NHPR is another podcast network. Some other shows that were mentioned were Newsworthy, Collecting Cars, Build Your SaaS, How I Built This, The Place We Find Ourselves. Another person said, depends on the context. Lately, I've been recommending Akimbo a lot. Other shows included Hidden Brain, Daily Tech News Show, Criminal, all of the bootstrapping podcasts. So I guess just that whole genre. 20,000 Hertz, which I would definitely recommend as well. I think I've mentioned previously, just a podcast about audio, and you don't have to be like an audio nerd to really enjoy it. It's kind of like if you ever listen to 99% Invisible about design. It's nothing to do with, you know, picking the right font or whatever, but has everything to do with telling the stories of why things were designed a certain way. So 20,000 Hertz is similar in that vein of talking about why the things we hear were picked or chosen or designed that way. And the final suggestion was The Daily, the New York Times daily news podcast, which I also love. Now, the fifth question was, how interested are you in starting a podcast? And people were asked to answer on a scale from 0 to 10, with 10 being starting one and 0 being not interested. And half of the people, 7 of them, said 10, that they were going to start at one, with 4 showing varying degrees of interest in starting one and 3 not really interested at all, which I would say kind of jives with what the feeling and the mood and the spirit is, I guess, in the air, in the ether, in the internet, of people, lots of people wanting to start podcasts. Not really even a question of whether a podcast is a viable thing to do or not these days. It's more just people wanting to, if they have time, if they have interest, if they have the ability. I just talked with someone here at the co-working space beside my office, and they're interested in starting two podcasts. I've got two ideas already. So it's definitely in the air. Lots of people wanting to start podcasts for a variety of reasons. The final question was, do you want to subscribe to my email newsletter? And I'm happy to say that 10 out of 14 of you said yes. So thank you. Once I figure out my email newsletter strategy, you'll be getting an email from me. So that's interesting in terms of the polls. Obviously with 14 responses, not a huge amount of responses to go off of, but definitely it will be interesting. I'll do it again, maybe in a year's time or 6 months time, and see if we get more people. And then as well as if listening times and interests change. So in wrapping up this series on the basics of podcasting, there's lots of things I want to talk about in future episodes of this podcast. Things like how to record a podcast with someone on the other side of the country or the world, how to build anticipation for a new podcast launch, ways to breathe new life into a podcast that you're getting tired of doing, how to find guests for your podcast interview, deciding on the format for your podcast, simple ways to improve the audio on your next recording, other things like should you make a video version of your podcast for YouTube, how to prepare for an interview when you're a guest or when you're the host, what to do when your guest shows up with just a laptop microphone, for example, and maybe even things like workflow stuff, like what's my workflow for creating a podcast. I'll just put a little plug here too for a community that I've started for podcasters who are interested in helping each other out, learning from each other, not just from me and paying me to help them with podcasts, but want to do it themselves. Castaways.club is a community of podcasters helping each other out. And it's a membership that you can join, and details are there, like I said, at castaways.club on the web, or a link will be in the show notes. If you got other questions about podcasting you'd like me to cover, here's your chance to get them on my list of future episode topics. You can reach me on Twitter at Lemon Production or on Instagram where I'm Lemon Productions CA. And I've got a little on Instagram there. There's a little ask me a question highlight, story highlight. So you can send me a question anytime there or just DM me on Twitter or Instagram. And of course, you can always just email me, chris@lemonproductions.ca. You can find all the details for this show on the web at podcast.lemonproductions.ca, including the various ways you can subscribe if you're not already subscribed. Please feel free to share this podcast with anyone who's interested in podcasting, either personally or for their business. And if you'd like to hear more from me, feel free to sign up for that email newsletter that's coming soon. lemonproductions.ca/newsletter has your sign-up details. This episode was written, edited, produced, and mixed by me, Chris Enns. My theme song is from Sounds Like an Earful Music Supply. Just a quick note on why I mentioned that who edited, wrote, and produced this episode, when obviously it was me, all for all of them on this particular podcast. I think it's a good habit of getting into for podcasts. Giving credit where credit is due for the various people involved in creating the various parts of your podcast, I think, is important. And just like any other medium, TV, music, movies, where credits are a way of highlighting all the people involved in creating that thing. If you listen to shows like The Daily, they'll spend almost a minute and a half at the end listing off all the people who are involved in creating the show each week, or each day, actually. And I think besides the recognition it gives those folks who are involved, it also reminds all of us who are in this podcasting side of the business that it sometimes takes an army of people to create something that sounds so simple and easy as a daily episode. All right, that's enough for now. Thanks for listening. Have a good day. Bye.